In 2 minutes you're gonna be better video editor than you right now. The goal is set, there are 7 tips to be discussed, let's start the clock. Have a template project file. First and foremost, you need to have a project file that is well structured, understandable and repeatable. Name your bins starting with 2-digit number and they will be sorted the same way every time. There is the link to my project file template down in the description.
Master effects!
If you want to add an effect to the clip that is being used multiple times on the timeline, for example talking head like this one, use master effects. In effect controls panel, click master effects tab. Anything you'll apply here will affect all instances of that clip on the timeline. Utility LUTs. Apply utility LUT in the basic section of Lumetri Color. It's basically the color conversion designed for specific camera and color profile. It's a great starting point for color correction and color grading. I like to use the ones included in FilmRiot's Cinematic LUTs pack. I'm not being paid to say that, it's just the best there is in my opinion. Audio sync. If you have video and audio clips that need to be synchronized, select them both on the timeline. Right click and choose synchronize. Now check audio and Premiere Pro will do the rest. Beware, if the audio from any clip is unrecognizable, it may not work. Also, if you need to synchronize a lot of clips at once, it may be better to use Red Giant's Plural Eyes plugin. Though it's cost money. Mouse re-editing. That's enough. Use Add Edit to All Tracks shortcut. By default is Ctrl plus Shift plus K, so make it a custom shortcut. And Q and W shortcuts to ripple trim the clips to the left and the right of the playhead respectively. This way you can edit without switching tools. Alt Option Dragging. If you're using motion graphic templates, and you should, you can copy its instances on the timeline by Alt Dragging. You select the instance to be copied, press Alt or Option on Mac on the keyboard and you click again dragging the clip to the new position. Congrats, now you can edit it as a separate instance. This works for all types of clips, by the way. Clip markers. If your animation covers or reveals the picture, you can mark the right moment with the clip marker. Now when you copy it, you can place it in the correct position right away. Wow, just in time! I wanna hear from you, what's your favorite editing tip? Comment down below, I really look forward to seeing you guys interacting with each other. And if that's your first time here, I think I've seen it before. I'd love you to hit that subscribe button. It was Peter, next time we're gonna start an awesome Premiere Pro effect series.
May the force be with you, I'm out.